Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Dorothea and I'm a crocheter behind Croby patterns. In today's video I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful crochet bag. This bag is perfect for groceries, books or even work in progress crochet or knit projects. Let me show you what you are going to need for this tutorial. You're going to need DK weight yarn in two colors. My main color is going to be blue, and for the contrasting color, I picked white. You're also going to need 3.5mm crochet hook, scissors, tapestry needle, and stitch markers. In addition to that, you're going to need a small amount of leather. Mine is not real leather, just an imitation of it, and something to punch holes into leather fabric. I will be using the hole puncher, but you can also use just a pointy needle and make holes with that. This video is brought to you by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives like you and me. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes on a range of topics, including graphic design, photography, video, fine art, music, illustration, and much more. And you will even find classes on crocheting, knitting, and other fiber arts. I have been a member of Skillshare for a while now, and I love learning new skills. Skillshare is specifically meant for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they are always launching new premium classes. Skillshare's entire catalog of classes is now offering subtitles in Spanish, French, Portuguese, and Dutch. I'm taking most of my classes while crocheting, doing the two things I like simultaneously, usually working on a new design and learning new skills. The class I'm planning to take next is called Productivity for Artists, Organizing Yourself for Success by Brooke Glaser. I want to be more productive, get organized, and share more of my work with all of you. And I think this class will be perfect for something like that. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare so you can start exploring your creativity today. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Let's continue with the tutorial. The bag is made of 5 panels in 3 different sizes. The largest panels are the front and the back panel. Each of those two is 115 rows high and 70 stitches wide. The next two are side panels. Each of them are 115 rows high and 15 stitches wide. The last one is the panel at the bottom of the bag. That one is a tiny bit smaller than the rest. It is 82 rows high and 15 stitches wide. In the next step, I'm going to show you how to crochet a panel on a little sample. I will use all the stitches and techniques I would use if I would make any of those 5 panels. You can then go on my blog and check the written instructions there to see how many rows and stitches you have to make, or just return to the previous part and follow the instructions there. We're going to need 3.5mm crochet hook and the color of yarn you are going to use as your main color. Create a foundation chain made of as many chains as you need. Mine is going to be made of 20 chains, however, yours will be much longer, it depends on the panel you are making. We're going to add one additional chain. This is going to be our turning chain. Once you have that, turn the row and work one single crochet into every chain. I'm going to use the back bumps, but you can use any loop on the foundation chain you like, just make sure you stay consistent with which one. Single crochet stitch is very simple. All you need to do is to insert the hook into the loop from the row below, grab the yarn with your crochet hook on the other side and pull it through. Once you have that, yarn over and pull the loop through both loops on your crochet hook, and that is your first single crochet stitch. Continue working all the way to the end of the row. Once your first row is complete, create one chain that is going to be your turning chain and repeat the steps. So work one single crochet stitch into each stitch from the row below. Don't skip or add any stitches. Each row has to have the same amount of stitches as previous one. That is very important for later when we will be making the pattern on top of the crochet panel. Thank you. Continue repeating rows until you reach the desired length. In my case, that is going to be 20 rows. So my sample will have 20 rows and in each row 20 stitches. The next step is the pattern. Each square in the pattern is made of 5 rows and 5 stitches. Let me show you a little trick. If you look at your fabric, you will see a bunch of lines. Between those two lines are 2 rows of single crochet stitches. Make sure you turn panel the right way, the way you will see 2 and 2 rows of single crochet stitches right from the beginning. Now we are going to make horizontal lines. Take one of the panels. I just want to remind you that not all of my panels have a pattern on them. The back panel and the bottom panel will stay, in my case, completely empty. I like it that way, but you can add the pattern to any of your panels you like or none of them. It's completely fine too. Let's start counting. Those first two lines are 4 rows of single crochet stitches, and this means we will have to divide the next in half, and that is where we are going to create our first row of slip stitches. Create a slip knot and attach it to the hook. Insert the hook into the fabric and crochet slip stitches in a straight line. At the end of the row, fasten off and cut the yarn. We're going to repeat that all the way to the end of the panel, and we are going to take care of the yarn ends later. Thank you. Vertical lines are a bit harder to make, but still manageable. Here we need to count the stitches in the row, but we have to be mindful about our turning chains at the beginning of each row. We're going to count 5 stitches, and then we're going to make a straight line made of slip stitches between stitch 5 and 6. If you're not completely sure if you're doing it right, just turn the fabric and check the slip stitches on the other side. If they look a bit off, then that means you have to try it again. And all you need to do is to find a different space to place your hook into. Repeat that all the way to the end of the panel. I'm going to make the lines on 3 of my panels, on the front one and the side ones. The back panel and the one at the bottom of the bag will stay empty, so completely undone. But that is something you can decide on your own. You can decorate a few of them, like I will do here, decorate all of them, or leave all of them completely empty. It's up to you. The next step is assembling all the pieces together. We are going to start with the side panels and attach those to the front panel with a row of single crochet stitches. I picked the thinner line to be on the outer side of the bag, but you can pick any of those two sides. Just make sure the yarn tails stay on the inner side of the bag. I'm making little knots on the inner side of the bag just to make sure the white lines of slip stitches are not going anywhere. After that, attach the back panel and the bottom panel. cut two straps of the leather fabric, 52 cm long and 3 cm wide. Make the holes with the hole puncher or the needle. Create two rounds of single crochet stitches on the top of the bag, join each round with a slip stitch, then cut the yarn and fasten off. Attach the straps to the back.
Thank you.
And here you have it, a simple crochet bag. I hope you like the tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. If you like crocheting and videos like this one, please consider subscribing. I post new tutorials and studio vlogs every month. Have a beautiful day, stay safe and well, and happy crocheting. Bye!